Scott Shelby is one badass character, so that being true, in this playthrough, he's actually gonna succeed ambushing the mansion. In my realistic playthrough, Scott Shelby was not so successful because I wanted to be as realistic and plausible as possible, and it is so unrealistic for one guy to charge into a mansion filled with pistol-equipped goons and him succeeding. So I actually had Scott Shelby fail in that playthrough, but in this playthrough, realism is out the window. Scott Shelby is going to be the most badass motherfucker ever. Check this out. Gets out of the car. After crashing into the place, he's like, I'm going to kind of stretch a little bit. And then, BAM! Heck yeah. It's time to be Gangsta Enga. Look at that. Oh yeah, shot him. He's done. He's just like walking in there. Perfect aim. Each shot, there's no miss. Dude, don't mess with this. Scott Shelby's the man. Look at that. He's just like, whatever. Totally unrealistic, right? I mean, just one guy taking out like... How many guys is that? I think that's like the 10th guy. 11th guy, maybe. Shoof. Up the path. He's so slow in his movement, yet he's just so fucking accurate. He's just out in the open like that. How can nobody hit him? Oh. I actually heard that the reaction time of the person that's reacting to it, rather than the person who initiates the action, it's like, I don't know, 0.2 seconds faster or something like that. Maybe that's why Scott Shelby is so amazing. But after killing all those goons, he comes to Golden, the Kramer guy.
Fucking asshole.
Please, don't hurt me.
Oops, I messed up. Oh my god, I expected to be a slap, but instead it turned. I expected him to do like a bitch slap, but no. It's a bitch punch. Oh my god. Scott Shelby is angry.
Your idiot son killed all those kids, didn't he? He's the origami killer.
No, no, he's innocent. He's not a killer. Not a killer.
Mm-hmm. Let's see what throwing around will change your answer.
You're a fucking liar. Now tell me the truth.
No, no, please. Don't hurt me.
Last chance.
I don't know. I swear. I don't know anything.
I think Scott Shelby is gonna give him one more chance, but this time just choking him to death. Holy shit.
Stop! Stop! I beg you.
See, this just seems totally out of Scott Shelby's character as well. That's why I also did not go through with Scott Shelby actually succeeding. But it is important to get this part.
Gordy always wanted his fun, you know? He wanted to be like the origami killer. He kidnapped that kid and... He held him under the water for a little too long. It was an accident. An unfortunate accident. He just wanted to play.
He had a sick, twisted way of the idea of play.
He was crying. He was so sorry for what had happened. Whatever he did. Gordy is my son.
No one will miss him.
What?
What? That boy, Gordy killed. No one will miss him. Just street trash, like so many others.
That's the wrong thing to say to a guy who's about to kill you.
You disgusting pile of shit.
John Shepard.
What about John Shepard? Why did you put flowers on his grave?
I own the construction site where he died. I never forgot. I've been putting flowers on his grave for 30 years.
Guess that's nice of him, I guess.
John had a twin brother.
This is so odd, Scott Shelby asking him this question.
He was adopted, I think.
The twin brother is looking right in front of you.
His mother should know. Her name is Anne. Anne Shepherd.
Ah, so that's how we come to know of Anne's character.
My heart!
My heart!
quickly. I need my pills.
This is the moral choice that comes up there. When Scott Shelby successfully, unrealistic, comes up here. Scott Shelby, though, because we know what kind of character he is, he's not gonna save him. Especially after he made that shrewd comment. Oh, you know, that boy was nothing. And I have a choice to leave. And Scott Shelby will leave.
Shelby! Come back! I fucking order you! Come back!